نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على سيدنا محمد رسوله النبي الأمين المكين الحنين الكريم الرؤوف الرحيم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين صدق الله مولانا العظيم Dear listeners and viewers, by grace of Almighty Allah, we have discussed the subject of the belief of resurrection and the belief of Day of Judgment in the light of Surah Al-Fatiha, specifically with reference of third verse, Malik Yawmiddin. In our earlier episodes, and we concluded the discussion on our last episode on this subject, on this aspect, and on this angle of the topic, that what is the necessity of the faith of in Day of Judgment? What is the necessity of the belief in resurrection? So we concluded the first aspect of the necessity, and that was the principle of continuity and the principle of dynamics and evolution in the life. So the question is that when life on this earth, on this planet, started before the appearance of life, there was non-existence of life. Then the first stage of appearance of life started from the existence of inorganic phase of life on the earth. Then it was, this phase was added by the existence of life in the form of organic existence. Non-existence was eliminated, was finished in the form of inorganic existence of life, and then inorganic existence of life continued till the organic existence of life started. And the question is that by the start of organic existence of life, inorganic existence was not finished. That remained continuing and still continues and will continue on, but a new phase of organic existence of life started. When organic existence of life started, at a certain stage, the animal world was commenced. A new phase was introduced in the history of life. So when animal existence started in the history of life, the organic life in the form of plants and trees was not closed. That continued, that continues, and that will continue. But a new phase was added to that. Now, after that phase, a time of appearance of man came. So human existence started on the earth. When human existence started on the earth, so the start of human existence in the history of life does not mean the end of earlier phases of life. They are continuing and they will continue. But a new phase of human existence was added to them. In the same manner, when all of the earlier phases were not finished, were not closed, so after this human physical existence in this world, it requires, the same concept of dynamics and evolution requires that there should be an addition of extra phase, and that phase would be the spiritual existence of life. And spiritual existence of life is life after death. Because if the man through his death eliminates, then his cycle of life is finished. So spiritual existence of the life of the man starts from the death of his physical life. And this completes the cycle. Because before the appearance of physical appearance of the life on the planet, on the earth, and before the appearance of physical life in this universe, before that, there was the existence of spiritual life in the form of jinns, in the form of angels. And in this material world also there was a physical, spiritual life prior to physical life, that is, it was in the form of light. As it is stated by the various scientists now, it has been established. It is stated before the Big Bang theory, it is stated, this means that the earlier universe was filled with high energy, short wave photons, and these were particles of light. So through the cosmic background radiation theory, the latest scientific theory named as cosmic background radiation theory, it says that before the commencement of the physical world, its earlier form was single unifying force. There was a single unifying force which had continued the existence of a cosmic egg, a unit of physical creation, a cosmic egg. It continued through a single unifying force. And before the Big Bang and before this physical existence, it has been established that the earlier universe before the physical life, earlier universe was filled with particles of light. So there was light before physical life started in this universe. So light means there was the existence of life in its spiritual form. So spiritual life did exist before the commencement of physical life. So same process is being repeated. After the finishing of the physical life, another spiritual life has to start. And that spiritual life would be starting partly in the form of Day of Judgment, and after passing through the Day of Judgment, an endless and everlasting spiritual life in the form of paradise and hell would start. So this is the concept of continuation of the life process, phase by phase and stage by stage. So this should continue. And the second aspect which requires the occurrence of resurrection and occurrence of the Day of Judgment, that is the principle of act and reward. And in scientific term, that is the principle of action and reaction. It is established fact that for every action there is a reaction. For every action there is a reaction. So reaction is a reward of the action. In the same way, we observe the application of the same philosophy in our routine matters and routine affairs. For example, if we drink cold water, it is impossible that we will not feel cooling. Drinking of cold water creates the result of cooling. If we put hand in ice, it will create cooling. If we put hands in fire, it would create heat. We will get the heat. If we eat food, the creation of energy is indispensable. If we eat poison, it will definitely harm. So every act has a specific result, that is its reaction, has a specific consequence, and this is its reward or award. So if eating of poison creates a reaction, if eating food creates reaction in the form of harm and in the form of energy, if drinking water creates reaction in the form of cooling, if fire creates reaction in the form of heating, so you can count thousands of the acts of human life. Every act possesses a specific consequence. So this is the reaction of the action. So if all of the actions bear reactions and consequences and awards and rewards and results, so how is it possible that if good deeds are performed, pious acts are performed, acts of piety, acts of helping the poor people, acts of God-fearing, acts of speaking truth, acts of doing good to other humanity, mankind, acts of performing worship, acts of fulfilling the personal, religious, spiritual and temporal duties, acts of committing the acts in accordance with the light of divine will, Allah's commandment, acts of obeying the commandments of the Prophet. So if good and pious acts are performed, is it possible that there should be no reaction to it? Is it possible that there should be no consequences for those acts? Is it morally acceptable that there should be no results for those pious acts? And at the same time, if bad acts are performed, anybody murders, anybody tells a lie, anybody violates the religious and Islamic law, spiritual law or divine law, anybody deviates from right path, anybody disobeys Almighty Allah's commandment or the commandment of the Prophet. So if anybody commits and performs bad acts, so would it be acceptable that bad acts should go without reaction? The bad deeds should go without results and without awards? So pious acts going without rewards and bad acts of violation going without awards? This thing is not acceptable as far as the moral conscious mind is concerned. So this concept of action and reaction requires that there should be a world of awards, and there should be a world of rewards, and there should be a world of reactions, and there should be a specific world of results and specific worlds of consequences. One can say, why there should be a specific world? Why not this world? The answer is that all of the actions do not create reactions and results and awards and rewards and consequences completely in this world for certain circumstances, because the systems are controlled by the people, courts are controlled by the people, witnesses are controlled by the people, establishing the fact or de-establishing the fact are controlled by the people. The social life, the environments of the social life are controlled by the people, by the governments, by the states, by the institutions. Sometimes the institutions and the laws and systems are good, sometimes are bad. Sometimes a murderer gets the punishment, sometimes his act of murder is concealed, nobody knows, and he succeeds to get avoid of the punishment. A liar sometimes tells the lie throughout his life, and sometimes in this world he does not get the punishment, goes on, dies. The murderer, the violator, the oppressor, the cruel man, sometimes crushing the poor humanity, crushing the poor people, crushing the weak people, violating the rights of neighbors, teasing and torturing the mankind, goes on committing oppressing acts and cruel acts and bad acts and immoral acts. But sometimes there are thousands of people in this world who do not get any reaction, who are not awarded with the punishments, who go away. And at the same time, those who were murdered, if the murderer did not get the punishment, so where did the murderer go? So the murdered passed away without the reaction on his murder, without the punishment to his murderer. So how would he be compensated? The oppressed, how would he be compensated if there is no punishment to the oppressor? The violated and the infringed and the damaged and the harmed person to whom harm was committed, to whom harm and damage was done, whose right was infringed, how would he be compensated if the harmer and infringer and violator is not punished? So we see thousands and millions of the cases in this way. So if this world is to be considered as the last world, and there would be no world afterwards, there would be no resurrection, there would be no day of judgment. So here there was no judgment on the case. The cruel passed away and the crueled passed away. The oppressor passed away and the oppressed passed away. The infringer passed away and the infringed passed away. The liar passed away and truth speaker passed away. The pious passed away and the wrong man also passed away without any award and reward. So if there is no world after this world, there was no judgment in this world. So if there is no judgment afterwards, if there is no judgment in life hereafter, if there are no rewards and punishments in life hereafter, if there is no concept of compensation of the infringed persons in life hereafter, then what would be the distinction between a good man and a bad man? What would be the distinction between good and evil? What would be the distinction between right and wrong? What would be the distinction between khair and shar? What would be the distinction between good and evil? Between piety and between violence? What would be the distinction between the two? So the moral conscious mind of the man requires compulsorily and inevitably and necessarily that there should be a life after this life. There should be a world after this world. And there should be a day of judgment, so that if there are wrong judgment passed here, so those people should be compensated in that court where there is no wrong judgment, where everybody is compensated, where everybody would be awarded, where everybody would be rewarded, where every sin committer would be punished, and where every wrongdoer would be punished, and where every pious person would be awarded. So that day of judgment or final judgment, that would be the day of complete and perfect compensation of each and every act, is known as Ad-Malik Yawmiddin, the day of judgment, the day of resurrection. So that's why Islamic faith requires the strong and profound belief in the day of resurrection and the day of judgment. After having discussion regarding the day of resurrection on moral basis, on intellectual basis, on philosophical basis, on ethical basis, and on other rational basis, now finally we want to discuss the matter as far as the occurrence of Qiyamah is concerned, occurrence of resurrection, occurrence of Qiyamah is concerned. Firstly, that would be the end of this physical world in scientific manner. As far as the scientific research is concerned, we should be clear on it, that as far as the life after the end of this life, the life hereafter is concerned, science cannot talk of it. Science cannot give any decision regarding it, whether this life would be existing or not, because this thing is out of the scope of scientific research. What science can do and what reality can be perceived through and known through science is only regarding the end, regarding the conclusion of this world. So if the end of this world is established through scientific research, through scientists of the today, if they accept that there would be an end of this world, so partly faith of Islam is established. Partly our faith regarding the day of judgment, regarding resurrection is established. When partly this faith is established and proved, first portion of the faith is proved that there would be an end of this world. So if the first portion is proved, automatically the second portion is accepted to be proved, because science is not in a position to have any idea of life which would appear after the end of this life, because that is beyond the scope of science. So coming to our scientific research and scientific developments, we will say that this is an established fact. The scientists and astronomers, they say, and I will read some of the paragraphs from the established writings of the astronomers and the scientists of today. They say that this world started and began with a big bang. And now, coming forward, say, most astronomers now believe that the universe started with a gigantic explosion, the big bang, about 15 million years ago. In any case, between 13 and 15 billion years ago, there was a big bang through which the life of the physical world started. According to the theory, a minute cosmic egg of immeasurable energy exploded. Matter, gravity, and electromagnetism were created. In the unimaginable blast, galaxies were formed, and the universe, physical universe, began to expand at enormous speed, as it is still doing today. It is going on expanding. Now, two other concepts have been proposed to explain the birth of the universe: oscillating universe and the steady state. Now we are talking of oscillating universe theory. The Big Bang idea has taken a step further by the oscillating universe theory. The present expansion, now this idea is coming towards Qiyamah, towards the idea of the end of the world. The science says the present expansion of the universe will be followed by a contraction. It will be followed by a contraction brought on by the force of gravity. The outward speeding galaxies will slow. So by the end of this universe, by the end of this physical world, they say that the contraction will take place by the force of gravity, and outward speeding galaxies will slow and stop, and the bars tossed straight up in the air, then they will fall back towards the center. Finally, the galaxies will collide, triggering a new Big Bang. So this is what has been established through oscillating universe theory, that there will be again, by the end of this physical world, there will be again a new Big Bang, as it was in the start of the physical world. And the galaxies will again collide. And then the most scientists believe that the universe will continue to expand, but that at a certain point, matter will collapse by the end of this world into huge black holes. This is the mentioning of huge black holes theory, the latest theory on astronomy. This is the huge black holes theory. Hydrogen and helium, which today constitute, will be used up in the thermonuclear fire of stars. This is to be noticed, that the burning and shining stars, these are shining due to the burning of hydrogen and helium. And science says that helium and hydrogen, which are used in thermonuclear fire of stars, that will be consumed, then no new stars will be born. And the universe will consist of, at that time, will consist of dead stars, meteoroids, rocks, and other cosmic debris. And beyond the ultimate black holes, they say eventually, after trillions of years having passed, two stars within a galaxy will collide with enough energy to kick one of the stars out of the galaxy. So two stars will collide with enough energy. So one of the stars will kick other star out of the galaxy. And the other stars remaining in the galaxy will fall into a lower energy orbit. These stars will fall into the galaxy coalescing into one huge black hole. And finally, it is stated, after more time, entire galaxies will spiral towards each other and collapse into super galactic black holes. Eventually, after so many years, these black holes will evaporate. Black holes will evaporate in burst of particles and radiation equal to the explosion of a billion one megaton H-bombs. So these will evaporate in burst of particles, and radiation would be a lot, explosion of the billion one megaton H-bombs. So concluding and summarizing the main points, we can say that the scientific development and the astronomy of the modern astronomy has established the fact that by the end of this world, again there would be a collision, as it was in the start of this physical universe. And number two, they say that the celestial bodies, the galaxies, they will collapse, and ultimately they will collide with each other, and the stars will fall down from the galaxies, from skies, they will fall down. A collision will take place, and a collapse of matter will take place. And thirdly, the astronomy, modern astronomy, has established that by the consumption of helium and hydrogen, the stars, shining stars, and planets, the sun and the moon and all of the stars, everything, who are in the galaxies, they will become lightless. The helium and hydrogen will consumed up, and there will be no more light and no more new stars shining. And the huge black holes which will come into existence, ultimately, number four, in the galaxies, they will again collide, and the matter will collapse, and everything will collide with each other. And the burst, they will burst as the particles, and the whole universe will be converted into particles. And they will evaporate as the particles of the dust, and everything would be scattered in the form of particles of dust. These six or seven points are the main points which can be easily derived and which are established through the modern astronomy. When this thing is established through modern astronomy and the modern scientific development, that there will be the end of universe, physical universe, and the end of physical universe would be in these shapes and would be in these forms. Now we conclude this thing up to this point, and in our next episode we will inshallah confront these astronomic and scientific results with, we will conduct a comparative study with the Quran in order to establish that what has been established and proved by the modern science regarding the end of universe, on this point what has been stated by Holy Quran 14 centuries before. Wama alayna illa al-balagh.